My name is Erica Ryder, and I lead the user experience team for the Tools and Platforms Experience Group at PayPal. I have a small design team of 5 designers, including myself, and we're responsible for somewhere between 60 and 100 products and well over 1,000 developers. For us to be such a small design team supporting such a large organization, we really had to be innovative in the way we solve problems. UXPin and Merge has actually helped us scale design without needing to add a large number of designers to our organization.
My name is Anthony Hand. I'm a UX designer at PayPal in the Technology Platforms and Experiences Group. Our group has been working with UXPin for about 2 years. Before coming to UXPin, I was using these other tools like Balsamic or OmniGraffle. They're really great for certain kinds of design tasks. But in order to create a prototype for a website, you know, I'd take a box and I'd drop it onto the canvas. In that box, I would have to do all the styling to make it look like a text field or to make it look like a checkbox.
Several years before I joined PayPal, I had this theory that to scale design effectively meant that we had to include developers and product managers in the design process. I just didn't know how we were going to do that. I knew the what, but I didn't know the how. Seeing Merge and UXPin open the door to understand the how, it really became the catalyst to our design process that we use now that we call DesignOps 2.0. So part of scaling that design was enabling product teams to do better design on their own, move faster, and reduce the gaps between design and development. This required us to actually be able to use the same components for design that we were using for development.
We've settled on using Microsoft Fluent UI controls for our internal tools development. And by doing that, we can design prototypes that leverage the exact same UI controls that our developer colleagues are using to develop these DevOps tools. So when I drag a button from our library in UXPin onto the canvas, that same button with the hover effects and the click effects and the internal font metrics inside of it, all of this is exactly the same and it renders the same in UXPin, it renders the same in our developer tools. So this brings a much higher level of fidelity to our prototypes than we've ever had before.
On the development side, what we've seen is engineering teams pick up a prototype that's been done and be able to get to working code within as little as one sprint. So stuff that used to take 4 or 5 months to do a design, to get through the design, work through all the issues, we were now seeing that 4 or 5 months cut down to 2 weeks, and we were seeing a rapid increase in speed getting from the design to working code and being able to iterate through that. At PayPal, we're a somewhat small team in a large organization, and for us, UXPin is really about how does a small design team support a really large developer organization. But it's the same for a company like a startup that's running really lean, because it allows you to move really fast and collaboratively, and it reduces the unnecessary conversations between designers and developers about how stuff works. It actually saves you a lot of time and helps you run a whole lot leaner.
We get a lot higher quality feedback from stakeholders. So the C-suite people and the directors, they're able to give us a lot stronger feedback about the ultimate direction and the features and the goals of these tools rather than just commenting about how these boxes don't look like a text field or whatever.
Now, with our designers mentoring and guiding design, but not actually doing the day-to-day production work for every single product out there, it frees them up to answer larger questions. So my design team spends 50% of their time supporting different product teams, and the other 50% of their time is spent on larger UX initiatives that can impact globally the organization. We focus on things like, how do we build trust between users in a platform? How do we build an intrinsic attachment between users in a platform? How do we build in user research into all of our products so we're not running studies, but we're constantly understanding how users use our products, where the gaps are, and how do we fix those? And how do we provide that data back to our product teams? UXPin and Merge were really the enabling factor for us to move in this direction. Stuff that used to take 2 to 3 months to just do the design now can be designed and delivered in that same time.
Not only that we could design faster, but the quality of our products were a lot higher. If we weren't using UXPin with Merge, then we would be heavily impacted. And ultimately, we'd be able to work on fewer products throughout the year. So I don't even want to think about that.
The benefit that UXPin and Merge has brought to us really is about allowing us to scale design effectively and efficiently. That means we can federate design across many product teams while maintaining consistency. This frees up time for our designers to actually focus on bigger picture issues that have more of a global impact.